get loosen up a little bit. Loosen up. Tonight is going to be so freeing. Some of us going to have to make some major shifts. But scoot this back, because I feel like it's going out, that little thing. You scoot it back to the pulpit. These shifts are going to be so freeing to you. You're really going to finally know what it means for your life to be like Jesus said. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. That's how your life's supposed to be, light and easy. The beginning of the year, God gave us a word. He said, this is the year of increased victories and increased love. We've dealt with, talked a lot about, I received, sir, increased victory. Amen. Right? And we really hadn't talked too much about love. But, listen, God is never late. He's always on time. And he has given me such a revelation. My love walk has increased. I mean, love has increased. But to understand what love really is, the biblical love, amen, not this, well, I love you, you love me, I love you if, you know. But it started with when we, was it last Wednesday, where we dealt with the, two Wednesdays ago, when we ended the service with the story of the prodigal son, the elder son, who didn't have the father's heart, but only wanted the father's stuff. He didn't have the father's heart. He only wanted the father's stuff and was quick to point out his brother's faults, was quick to point out his brother's wrongs. Amen. And so the title for tonight is The Heart of the Father, Vessels of Love. Amen. Before I go there, let me just give you this, because I want you to understand something. Some of y'all might not understand what covering, even pastor and all that good stuff, connection. let me just give it to you. The Holy Spirit gave it to me as I was there in Florida, and then I'll get back to the word. Is that all right? He said, too many got covering twisted. Covering is not your covering, your pastors do for you. Give to you. But they are to serve you by overseeing a divine assignment that one can submit to. And when one joins in that vision, the covering gets to work. And one will be fulfilled and fully satisfied. A covering. They oversee a divine assignment from heaven and assist people in people's growth to fulfill that assignment. That those people would grow up so they won't be as children tossed to and fro by every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men, but that they will grow up in love as the Father desired. That's covering. Not they don't call me. They don't have to. You only got to call the baby. Shouldn't have to. See what I'm saying? All I am, all she is a steward, an overseer of the master's field. So look to him. Jesus, man, y'all missed that one. All I am, all she is a steward, an overseer of the master's field. This is his church. This is not my church. This is not her church. This is his church. So look to him. They, my covering shouldn't have to be after me, but they should be equipping me so I won't be a child tossed to and fro. You see what I'm saying? They should be feeding me good meals that I can grow up in all things. And I would be able to speak the truth in love. Amen? Okay, so let's get to work. I hope that helps. Now, so looking back, let me just give it. Can I give it to you the way God gave it to me? The way Holy Ghost gave it to me? Praise God for the Holy Ghost. Boy, you don't understand how free I am. No, I mean, I don't know. Oh my gosh. The weight of this church came off of me. No, I'm serious. I'm Mr. Marcel, free. If you'll get this right, your life will be so free, you're finally really going to understand what it means to cast your care on him because he cares about you. Are you ready to get to work? Okay, let me just start off by saying this. Okay, how many of y'all seen that sticker, Not of This World? How many of you got that sticker? Don't be afraid. You got it? Throw that thing away. Yeah, you are. You are of this world. I'm sorry, whether you like it or not, you are of this world. If you were not of this world, you would not need Jesus. Jesus said, you are from below. I am from above. Jesus said, you are of this world. I am not of this world. Jesus Christ was the only one not of this world. If you're not of this world, why does the weight of the world keep beating you down? Why do situations keep causing you to worry if you're not of this world? You see what I'm saying? No, because, and so watch this. See, the devil knew Jesus was not of this world. That's why he told him, hey, you could turn this stone into bread. You and I cannot turn the stone into bread. Why? Because we're of this world. Jesus was not of this world, so Satan knew you could turn this stone into bread. You and I could not jump off a cliff. Because we're of this world, we got something called the law of gravity. But he knew you could jump off the cliff. Why? Because he knew you're not this world. And so Jesus says, look, I'm from above. You're from below. I'm not of this world. You are of this world. Those are his words, not mine. And so because I'm in this world, I need Jesus. Because I'm in the, because, but, and so then he says, look, I didn't come to tell, I only came to tell you what I heard the Father tell me to tell you. I'm only going to tell, and then another place he said, I'm only going to tell you what he taught me to teach you, because you're of this world, and with what I give you, you'll be able to overcome this world. My God. Okay, let me give you these couple of scriptures real quick, because He says, that's John 8:23. You are from beneath. I am from above. You are of this world. I am not of this world. And then he said, John 8:28, as my Father has taught me, I speak these things to you. As he taught me, see, God didn't just send Jesus. He taught him before he sent him. He said, watch this. He said, oh, Jesus. Where is it? Mm-hmm. See, so he said, as he taught me, I'm going to speak these things. Yeah. He said, he that sent me is true. John 8:26. And I speak, don't put any scriptures on screen. Don't put any scriptures on screen. Just leave me. I heard Apostle say that. He said the impartation comes from me. All right? You should have a Bible. If you don't have one, raise your hand. We got some. We'll get you one. I speak. He that sent me is true, and I speak to the world. those things which I heard of him. But if you're not of this world, then he ain't talking to you. He said, I came to speak to the world those things which I heard from the Father. Someone say, talk to me, Jesus. Talk to me, Jesus. He said, I came to tell you what I heard. You know what he's saying right here? You know what he's saying right here? I know something. Jesus is saying, I know something. Listen to me. Listen to me. I know something. I know some things because I'm not from here. I'm from above. I know some things. I'm not of this world. You're from this world. I know something. Listen to me, Jesus is saying. We need to take what he said more serious. And so now let's just pause for the cause, because now that means, Caleb, everywhere I see in red, okay, Luke 18, we've been teaching on that Sunday, Luke 18, 1, men ought to always pray and not faint. Yes, sir. That means, Elder Jose, God taught Jesus that before he sent him. Come on. He said, Deidre, God said, Jesus, come here. Tell them they should always pray. Tell them don't lose heart in prayer. Yeah. Tell them don't quit on prayer. That's a secret, ho. Don't quit coming and don't quit knocking. Don't quit coming for that thing to get fixed. Don't stop. Don't lose heart. Jesus heard that from God. I want you to start seeing it like this. Well, you heard him teach. God told him that first. He said, I'm only going to tell you what he taught me to teach you. And with this, you'll be able to overcome this world that you're in. Okay, so here we go. So we see who taught the prodigal son story. Jesus. And that prodigal son came back. He was ready to spill his guts. The father said, I ain't want to hear that. You're home. That's all that matters, is you're home. Okay, here we go. So, are y'all ready for this? Come on, say this. My love walk has to increase. See, when your love walk increases, everything else has to increase. Amen. Your victories have to increase. Why? Faith works through. Love. Faith works through. And he worketh miracles among us by the hearing of our faith. But faith is going through a pipeline of love. Come on. The bigger the pipeline, the bigger he can get some things through there. Yeah. Come on. The more he can get through there. Come on. Little pipeline, little flow. Yeah. What if you got one of them commercial pipeline of them commercial? How big are them commercial water lines? Huh? That pressure. You got to flow. Okay? Okay, so here we go. We're going to really look at love, okay? So, are y'all sure y'all ready? Are y'all ready for the weight to come off you? Y'all ready to breathe easy? You ready, okay, even some of you right now, you ready to lose some of that condemnation the world has been trying to put on you? Oh, let me say it like this. Are you ready to lose some of that condemnation Christians have been trying to put on you? Are you ready to lose that guilt that even believers have been trying to put on you? Because they knew some scriptures that talked against about what you were doing. How many of y'all ready to be free? All right, let's get to work. So John 8. So now this is on the back end of John 8. So then you come up to the front end of John 8. Now watch this, glory to God. I got to try to stay calm, Juan, because this is, my goodness. So let me just go ahead. I thought I was going to be able to stay up here, but I'm not. I'm coming down, so let's make adjustments on the phones and stuff. Everything we got to make adjustments on so online can see. Okay, help me, Holy Spirit. John 8. Okay, now this, I'm going to give it to you the way Holy Ghost gave it to me. Okay? Now, so Jesus says, now this is not a parable, this is real. Okay, this is not a parable, this is real. The parable, not the parable, the testimony of the adulterous woman.
Rebecca said, "Why are you looking at me, Pastor?" I was just, you were right there. I was just talking to her. Are y'all ready for this? Bow for the Holy Ghost, man. And so Jesus, I'm just going to kind of paraphrase, but I can quote a lot of the scripture because this has been in my heart since Orlando. I've just been meditating this, studying this, pondering this. Why was that funny? That was funny. Oh. And so, watch this. Are you ready? So watch this. They bring a woman. Here come the Pharisees with a woman, and they tell him, "Jesus, we caught this woman in the act of adultery. Law says we got to stone her. What say you?" Now, let me just give picture, quick picture real quick. The Bible says Jesus bowed down and began writing on the sand, and then King James says, "as though." As though. If you study that in the Greek, that denotes as though he didn't even hear them, Stephen. Come on. He pretended he didn't even hear them. Yeah. You know what he was saying? "I don't want to hear that. Was it a lie? What was it a lie? Was it gossip? No, this is, was it a rumor? We caught her." The Bible says he acted like he didn't even hear him. So Ron said, and then he stood up and he said, "He who is without sin, cast the first stone." And then he went back, started writing on the sand. Many believe, this is rare that I do this, but many believe that he was writing their sin. Because the Bible says, then one by one, stones fell and they began to walk away. And then he stands up, he says, "Woman, where art thou accusers? Is there no one left to condemn you? She said, "No one, my Lord, there was no one left to condemn you." He said, "Well then, I don't condemn you either. Go thy way and sin no more." Now, let me just stop you real quick, because here's what the Holy Ghost told me. He said, "Marcus, why is it that Christians take up a position Jesus Christ didn't even want? Why do Christians want the job of condemning others when Jesus said, 'I don't condemn you. I'm not here to judge you. I'm not here to condemn you.' So then why do Christians always take the position of judging other Christians, of judging the unbeliever, when Jesus said, 'I don't want that job. That's not my job. I don't want it.'" Now, let me paint the picture real quick that before we get going. I got to slow my spirit down. Watch this. Holy Spirit told me, "Marcus, she came to Jesus unwillingly." She didn't want to go to Jesus. No, let's look at it. This chick just got through having sex with a man that was not her husband. She may have been half dressed. And now they tell her, "We're going to take you to a Jewish priest that calls himself the Son of the Most High God. See what he says to do with you." Do you think she wanted to go to Jesus? Come on, you're like, "No, I ain't going." And then he said he's here to fulfill the law. He really going to make sure I get stoned. I ain't going to Jesus. She came unwillingly. Listen to what the Holy Spirit said. He said, "But it was in the presence of real love that she got set free." So Holy Spirit told me to tell some of you, it don't matter how you're coming, just keep coming. It don't matter how you're coming, just keep coming. Because when you're in the presence of real love, I don't know what service it'll be, I don't know what moment it will be, but something's going to break off your life. Something's going to break off your life. Jesus said, I ain't here to judge you. So if Jesus ain't here to judge you, I'm not here to judge you either. If you're coming high, just keep coming. If you're coming half drunk, man, just keep coming. Because it's in the presence of real love, you get set free. And she was able, he said, now go, and you can sin no more. I bet Jesus. That was this one incident not too long. This one person kept coming in just insane. Holy Spirit never told me to tell them anything. He said, any chance you get when they're here, give them a hug. That was all he would tell me. Give them a hug. Love on them. They know what they're doing wrong. They don't need you to tell them. They don't need you to talk about it behind closed doors. Love them. That's all I did. And one day, I don't know when it happened, that person got set free. Now hold on, watch. Let me say it to you like this. Watch this. Listen, before I continue on. See, watch this. Jesus said in John 6, write down John 6, 43 and 44. Jesus said to them, do not murmur among yourselves. Jesus Christ, my God. Hold on, no, let me wait for that. I'll come back to that in a minute. I was talking about in the presence of real love, you get set free. And then Jesus told her, now go and sin no more. Because he knew there was a grace there to help her do what she'd been wanting to do. Yes, sir. What she was wanting to stop doing. So I can almost guarantee you some gentlemen callers came by a couple days later. Hey, girl. What's up? Nothing. Hey, well, what's up? Nothing. Well, you know what she said? It ain't me no more. I found real love. I found real satisfaction. That was not real love. I found real love. You see, let me just tag I wrote down. The antidote for all sin is Jesus Christ. When we stumble, our first instinct, like Adam, is to withdraw from God. But the real cure for whatever you struggle with is only found in Jesus. Who knows, oh holy night? Oh holy night. Uh-huh. Keep going. Listen. Long lay the world in sin, ever pining. Till he appeared. I was laying in sin. I was laying in error until he appeared and my soul finally found its worth. I found my value. I found my worth. And it's in Jesus. My God. She thought it was in all these other cats. But the moment she found Jesus. You may make mistakes. You may miss it. We may mess up. Peter did. And all he did was lift up his arm. And Jesus raised him up. Watch this. Here we go. So now, whew, glory to God.
got 16 minutes left. So let's come back to this story right here. This true story. Where one by one they put down their stones. Amen? Amen. One by one they put down their stones. Their stone. Now right here, if you look up stone in the Greek, it is a stumbling stone. To cause them to stumble. Cause them to stumble. They threw down their stumbling stone. I'm calling the church as a whole, throw down your stumbling stone.
Yes.
I'm telling you, this is the direction this church is going. This, we're making a shift.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And I'm going to be like Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Now, there'll be times you have to, what's it called? Confront.
Yes, sir.
But never condemn. Jesus, watch it. Okay, now watch this, watch this. See,
come on, Pastor.
Jesus answered them and said, do not murmur among yourself.
Come on.
No one, listen to Jesus, the heart of the Father. He said, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him to me. And I'm going to raise him up in the last day. So in other words, Jesus, Shane, when did you get saved? He's shaking. Why are you shaking? Are you cold?
Second week of March.
Are you cold or are you just trembling? No, it's not me. When Shane came to Jesus, watch this. Do you remember when Shane came to Jesus? I know y'all good friends, so I know you would not say this, but we're going to pretend. Okay, can we pretend for a second? We're going to pretend. Samara was there that beautiful day. He came up to the altar. And then she turned to Dustin like, can you believe this? He was just smoking before you got here. Now you got to act holy. Who do they think they are? I know what they've been doing.
Come on.
I know she wouldn't say that she loves Shane like a brother. I'm just an example. But Jesus is saying, don't murmur among yourself. Because this is the Father's doing. This is the Father's doing. The Father drew him to me. The Father drew him to me. Jesus is saying, when we get saved, when somebody returns, like the prodigal son, when he returned, that's what Jesus was giving us a picture of. He was telling the older son, no, this is a happy day. Oh, happy day. This is a happy day for your brother, my son. He was lost, but now he's found. He was dead, but now he's alive. So Jesus says, don't murmur among yourself. When you see someone that was at the bar Saturday night come to church Sunday morning, the Father is drawing them. They're just going through some things within themselves. But the Father is drawing them. Don't need to murmur among yourself. That's not our job. That you're throwing a stone. He said, but I do want you to know something. Don't murmur because watch this. Okay, watch it. Let me put it like this. See, he said, don't murmur because when you start talking about Peter's, when you start talking about the adulterous woman, when you start talking about the younger son, the prodigal son, you start to sink.
Come on, Pastor.
And Jesus said, you're going to watch me raise them up. And so the elder son had to sit and watch the father raise up the prodigal son.
Yeah.
Jesus said in one place, I know that the love of God is not in you. So I'm asking you, do you have the love of the Father in you? Let me give it to you like this. So let me break it down. Y'all sit down. John 12:47, write this down. Jesus said, if anyone hears my words. Now hold on, let's go back to the adulterous woman story. Because let's look at the whole story. The Pharisees were right there, right? And he said, they said, this cat acting like he didn't hear us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're supposed to be stoning her right about now.
Yeah.
And he acting like he didn't want to hear it. I brought him some juicy. Sin. Because she is caught in the act. You know how many, a lot of Christians would kill to hear some be right in the mess. I was there. I seen him. And he didn't want to hear it.
Come on.
And then finally, one by one, they walked away. Now what? Wait, they walked away.
Yeah. Come on.
Someone say they're gone.
They're gone.
Reverend Marcel, Minister Shane, go over there in a little huddle. So they're over there, watch this, having a holy meeting. And Jesus over here with the adulterous woman. I wish. They didn't hear him tell her, go and sin no more. See, he was letting her know, I don't agree with what you did. But that's not going to stop me from loving you. Come over here this side. Now this side, you know what they're saying.
I can't believe it.
He must be on the side of sin.
Oh, come on.
He must be that church that allows sin. They allow sinners in the church.
Oh. Come on. Yeah, absolutely.
He must be one of them churches that let sinners in the church.
Yes, sir.
What kind of church? I'm glad we're holy over here.
Oh, over here.
I'm glad we're not like them. That's a holy meeting, huh? Listen. So here we go. Jesus said, okay, thank you. If anyone hears me, hears my words, watch this, and does not, oh, no, and does not believe. Listen to what he said. Even if you hear my words and you still don't believe, you know what he said? I don't judge you.
Wow.
Natasha, what? Yeah. You have to look on the screen. I'm right here. She was looking at the screen. I'm right here. That's for the people like in the poll. And then Ivan. No, I'm just messing with you, man. Jesus said, even if you hear my words and still don't believe, I don't judge you.
Amen.
So if, as he was on the earth, so am I. Or he said, as I was on the earth, so are you. So then, Now, before we think we can just get away with sin, hold on. Because then he says, but you do have one that will judge you.
Come on.
The Word will judge you.
Yeah.
The Word will judge you. Not the believer. Are y'all getting any of this? Let me break this word judge down for you. Can I break it down real quick? I got 6 minutes.
Break it down.
I got 6 minutes because no one's falling out, so I got in early. judge, condemn. So Jesus said, I don't condemn you. Well, look, let me, I didn't finish the scripture. He said, I do not judge him, for I did not come to judge the world. I don't judge because that's not why I came. I came to save. We do have one that will judge us. The word will judge us. There's no repentance. The word is going to get to work. Okay, so, but as far as us, okay, so then, judge, condemn, punish, watch this, conclude. In other words, I'm not here to make a conclusion about you. I'm not here to make a conclusion about you. If you sat in here, heard the word, didn't get nothing, ain't gonna make no changes, I'm not gonna make a conclusion about you. Why? There's still hope. Oh, y'all didn't get that. There's still hope. There's still hope. There's still hope for you. You still got time. Jesus. Because that's not my job, Mark. I'm not here to condemn you. I'm not here to make a conclusion about you. Just because you didn't want to let go of anger. Watch this. Hold on. Whoa. Determine. Huh? I'm not here to make a determination. I'm not here to make a determination about you. I'm not here to, are you ready for this? Call into question.
Ooh, come on.
I don't need to call you in for questioning. Oh, y'all getting, come on. Oh, y'all taking notes. Okay, y'all taking notes. Call into question. No, because see, look, if that's what you want to do, that's on you. Okay, let me give it to you like this. Let me give it to you like this then, okay? Watch this. See, when you and I, this is the love of the Father. Jesus taught this. This is the love of the Father. Are you ready for this? The love of God frees you from people's failures and people's mistakes. I'm free. No, I'm free. If that's what they want to do, go for it. I'm not going to tell them that, but if that's what they want to do, but now you got to reap your consequences. I don't. Now, if you want help, I'll be here for you to help you. Oh, you see, I'll pray, but other than that, we don't need to discuss it. We don't need to talk about the adulterous woman. We don't need to talk about how many times she messed up. All we need to do is rejoice that she was lost and now she's found. We don't need to talk about the prodigal son and everything he wasted, everything he did while he was out there. All we need to do is rejoice because he was dead and now he's alive. So regardless how you're coming, just keep coming. You see, watch this. See, so when you, well, this is the love of the Father. When you have the love of the Father, it frees you from people's mistakes. It frees you from people's failures. So Hope, I could come to you and I could be like, hey, Hope, man, so what do you think about so-and-so, man? It was bad what they did, huh? You know what she can say? I don't have to have an opinion. You know what she can say? I don't want to hear that. You know what she can do? Act like she didn't hear me. You know what she can do? Ignore me. Why? I don't have to have an opinion. Yeah, but they've been going to church. I'm free. I'm free from their mistake. I'm free from their sin. If he set me free from my sin, I don't want y'all bringing up my old sin. What makes you think they want you to bring up theirs? How many of y'all feel lighter already? Yes, how many of y'all feel so much? Because you were carrying a yoke that was never meant to be.
Wow. Come on, Pastor.
Yeah, but it was bad. It was pretty, they caught her in the act. It's pretty bad. Brought her to the priest. Pretty bad. Jesus said, I don't want to hear that. Why? I want to love her. When the prodigal son came, the father said, I don't want to hear that. Why? I want to love you. Yeah, but if you do, I'm going to leave. And the prodigal son, he's just like, well, I'm just going to keep dressing him. You really want to control the father? You really want to try and control the father? Go for it. No, I'm free. Come on, someone shout, I'm free.
I'm free.
From people's failures.
From people's mistakes.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free. I see now watch this. Now you don't gotta get mad when if they mess up. You don't gotta get bitter. Why? They don't have to answer to me. They ain't gonna answer to me. Now someone said it. You're gonna have to answer to the word. That's why he said, heaven and earth pass away, but the word is going to last. Why? It's going to do some judging. I get to see. No, you're going to have consequences. You're free from my judgment, but you're not free from your consequences. You see? I don't have to have an opinion. I'm free from thinking about and making judgments about, and so therefore I'm free to love them. That don't mean I agree. Right. No, it don't mean I agree. Right. But this way I get to keep loving. So the next time someone wants to bring you some juice, let them know, I don't have to have an opinion. I don't want to know that. Yeah. Pretend you didn't hear them. So if I didn't hear them, how can I spread what I didn't hear? Oh, I wasn't finished yet. Judge. He said, I do not judge him. I don't think. I don't think against him. What does 1 Corinthians 13 say? For love thinks no evil. I don't want to think wrong about him. Yeah, but it's true. It don't matter. That's not between me and them. Even if it was about me. Oh, geez. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, but you don't want to hear what they said about you? No. I don't need to know. It don't matter. I'm free. And that's why he's going to keep raising me up. He's going to imitate what Jesus talked about doing. And then he says right here, watch. I didn't come to pass sentence. So if Jesus didn't, why do we? If Jesus didn't, why do we? This is a good foundation to stop here. Okay. By all this, Jesus said, by all this. Philippians 1, 9 and 10. Philippians 1, 9 and 10. And then I'll get ready to close. Philippians 1, 9 and 10. How many of y'all free?
Amen.
Did y'all get anything tonight?
Amen.
I mean, really?
Amen.
He said, we don't got to counsel about what so-and-so did. No, I don't need to talk about it. We don't need to talk about it. I don't need to talk about it. And see, God told me, you know, that's my church. I said, yeah. He said, all right, then you let me make the judgments. So now y'all, now those of you in helps, you know the protocol. You know the rules of engagement. For example, if you're on praise and worship, you know you have to be tithing. So if I come to you and I say, man, you've been tithing? My MVB overseers, you know you have to be tithing. So if I come, Rebecca say, hey, Rebecca, you've been tithing? Yes, sir, I've been tithing. Let's pretend like she wasn't, but she's a faithful tithe. Rebecca, you've been tithing? Yes, sir. And I know she has it. Watch this. You know what I say? Okay. No, I don't need to call her into question. I don't need to give her the third degree. Okay, no, but see, that's now that's between you and God now. If it would have been this year and you needed help, maybe you, man, Pat, you know, Pat, things being caught. You know what? Okay, we can work with that. Yeah. Hey, you know, we can help you, you know, some budget, get some things so you can maybe find out where you've been, maybe being a bad steward. But other than that, see, I can work with that. But now, see, if there's sin, lying, now, okay. So now, you know what I'm doing? Now I'll just keep loving. You know what the word's going to do? It's going to get to work. And unless there's true repentance, the word will expose, it will reveal, and then once again, if there's not true repentance, it will remove. See, so I don't have to remove you. The word will remove you. Why? It's not my church. The word will remove you. What am I going to do? I'm going to keep feeding you. See, I'm free to keep feeding you a good meal. I'm free to keep tending and give you a good, Jesus, man, a word that will heal. A word that will empower, a word that will strengthen. See, I'm free to love you. I'm not going to sit because of you. If you keep lying to my face, it will get me upset. Why? Because I'm of this world. See, but if I don't call you into question, that's all I need, that one. Now I can let the word work. Why? Not my church. It's his church. Oh, y'all miss a good point. Do y'all know how free I am? I am so free, Reverend. So free. He'll say, well, he'll cut our legs. No, you cut your own legs. No, I don't got to cut your legs. No, you cut your own legs off. I'm not me. I'm not going to do it. Why? Jesus did it. So if Jesus did it, why am I? You'll do it yourself. Church, are y'all, do you see how free you should be living? Do you see how light your life should be? Do you see how easy your life should be? God said, leave that to me. What God needs are vessels of love. Finna close. Philippians 1, 9, and 10. I pray that your love may abound yet more at your, so your love was already abounding, but he said, I want you to take your love to a whole nother level. Amen. Come on, someone say, take my love to another level. Come on, take my love to another level. I pray my love abounds more and more. More in knowledge and all judgment. Now, that's not for you to judge. But judgment, well, I can judge those things in my life. See, I got to judge sickness and disease. Judge lack and poverty. Judge depression. You're not supposed to be in my life. I got a verdict for you. You see? Watch this. That you may approve things that are excellent, so that way you can be sincere and be without offense to the day of Christ. His will is that I be without offense until the day Jesus comes back. See, offense shouldn't have no room in your heart. But if you keep letting people tell you things about people, you're making room for offense. You're making room. That's why Jesus said, I'm going to pretend to hear you. I don't want to hear that. But I know if I keep loving, something can happen. Because God works through vessels of honor. And so what he needs, see, watch. If you start throwing stones, you start murmuring, now you are a vessel of dishonor that God cannot use. But one thing he uses are vessels of honor, especially vessels of love. And so because love, why couldn't everyone else get everyone free in the Bible? Because they were not vessels of love. But the moment a vessel of love stood in the midst, said, I don't want to hear that. I'm just going to love this guy. I'm just going to love this girl. God said, I can move through you. Okay, so, watch this. Write down, God needs vessels of love. Luke 5. Jesus tells him, hey, the multitude followed him. He said, man, I need to be able to get this word to them. Can I borrow your ship? He gets in the ship. He gets in the vessel and tells him, pull out a little way. Oh, Jesus, now hold on. Watch. Pull out a little ways and let me preach. He preached hours. He didn't worry about no clock. And nobody was falling out. No, kids got school. Yeah. I'm always going to tease her about that now. We're just having fun. What's your name? Stephanie. You know that story? My wife got on to me because I preached long. She said, babe, we got to go. It's late. I said, babe, but it was powerful. She said, well, nobody falling out. I guess it wasn't too good. I was just teasing. So that's what I'm talking about. Christian to the nursery, please. I like how y'all put please on there. Very polite. But see, let me tell you this. We're going to have to, because God gave my wife and I a word. He said, this is before I was ever a pastor. And the man of God said, there was a sea of people following you. Yes. And God gave us another word. He's going to give us the kind of resource to build. Not just this number could come, but five times this number. He said he's going to do it himself and sign his name on the bottom. And I can't wait to tell y'all Sunday how because my love increased, victory has increased. God said that we started the year blessed. We're going to end it more blessed. I've got a testimony coming to you about this church that I just found out in Florida. And so it flows from the head down. So from God's house to your house, that Sunday. I need your love walk to increase. Because victory is going to increase if your love walk will increase. And so Jesus said, pull out a little way. He let them preach. That was love right there. They had worked all day. They're ready to go home. But I'm going to let you use my ship so you can preach to these people that are hurting. That's love. They were tired. Yeah, get up early and go to work. And after it was over, he said, he knew they hadn't caught anything. There had no fish on the boat. Nothing to talk about, at least. Pull out a little ways, cast your net, and pull up a drought. A drought is a large haul of fish. He was already telling them, we're going to get a large catch. Yeah. We've been out here all night. We haven't caught anything. Huh? Yeah. What will happen? Because it was a vessel of love. Overflow came to that ship. If you will just be a vessel of love, overflow is going to come to your house. Watch this. Listen. People should be getting the overflow of our relationship with God. Jesus said, by this all will know you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. They will know who you belong to. Your family, they should know you belong to Jesus. Amen. Does your family know you belong to Jesus? Not because you tell them, but by the way you love them. Not because you tell them, but because by the way you love them. Does your coworkers know that you belong to Jesus? Not because you tell them and you got the lingo down. Can I go ahead and go there now? Do your enemies know who you belong to? Do they know they belong to Jesus? Oh, in here. See, so how much of God can come through me? How much of God can come through me? Yeah, but they were so rude. So? No, that don't matter. And you ready for this? I don't have to go tell everybody that they were rude too. I ain't got to go tell everybody, Miss Candace was so rude to me. And she ain't even rude. That's just her expression. That's just how, that's just who she is. That's just, you know. No, she's not rude. I'm not going to make her be like me. I'm not going to make her be like Della. I'm not going to make her be like Cindy. She's got to be her. Amen. But I can speak the truth in love. See, so they're rude. But so? Somebody is rude to you, so? And I don't have to go tell anybody. Why do I want to try and get you to look at somebody else different? Why am I going to throw a stone? Are y'all getting anything, church? I'm closing, babe. So then, act like you're blessed. Act like the blessing says to act. I'm closing here. Last scripture. We're going to pick up tithes and offering, and we're going to go home. Go eat. I'm hungry. What did I say? Matthew 5. Matthew 5. Okay. See, because we've got to get, Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus be the center of my life. Okay. You ready for this then? Love your enemy. Never mind. It's not about you, Jesus. Because the first thing he's going to tell me is love. So much so. See, we think God is just happy with this emotional high. He said, you honor me with your lips, but your heart is far from me. If you don't love your neighbor, who you can see, how can you love me? See, we in the church are more happy with clap your hands and shout unto the God with the voice of triumph. We're satisfied there. Don't push me any further. Because this scripture has to be added with this scripture. Blessed are you when men revile you, persecute you, say all manner of evil against you falsely for my name's sake. Even if it was true, because they said it about her and it was true. Huh? They said it right? Yep. It was true. Yeah. And look what he said do. Rejoice! Come on, say it again. Rejoice! Be exceedingly glad when they talk about you. Be exceedingly glad when they persecute you. Be exceedingly glad when they speak all manner, all kinds of evil against you. For great is your reward in heaven. Are y'all seeing this? So then, the next time they talk about you, clap your hands. And shout out to God with glory. The next time they persecute you, clap your hands. Don't go tell everybody. I can't believe this. No, believe it. They're going to do it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Don't worry about it. Don't give it another thought. Why? So I can be free to love them. Act like you didn't hear it. Clap your hands. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Be exceedingly glad, not exceedingly mad. Be exceeding glory to God. And you know what Jesus is doing? Jesus is standing up. He said, I'm going to raise them up. And he said, I'm going to do it in front of everybody that talked about him. I'm going to do it in front of everybody that murmured against him. I'm going to do it in front of everybody that tried to keep them down. And the ones that thought they were holy, ones that throwing the stone, they're in the same position of life. It's time for our love walk to increase. And so God's going to fill this church. We have to be kind. I mean, we got to treat people like royalty. Because you're going to see some of your enemies come in. You know, Plainview's a small town. Can I go ahead and go there? You may see someone that was with your spouse. You won them. Don't worry about it. You won. What are you worried about? You won. You got your husband or your wife. You won. What are you worried about? We're going to have to be kind, rejoice, be happy, no murmuring, no complaining. Why? Because Jesus said so. I'm just going to go back to the world. Bye. No, see, because I can't stop you. I'm not going to try. And I'm not going to judge you. No, I'm not. Jesus said, if you don't want to hear my words, he said, I'm not going to judge you. So if Jesus ain't going to judge you, you know what I'm not going to do, Crystal? I ain't going to judge you. I ain't going to think, I'm like, man, Crystal, God, I've said that and she left. Like, well, I don't know what's wrong. No. I'll love you, pray for you, ask God to bring you back, but I'm not going to quit losing sleep. Let your love walk increase. Let it abound more and more. Y'all feel that? Just light as a feather. Some of y'all light as a feather. Some of y'all stiff as a board. I want to talk about people. Taking your only hobby away, huh? Come on, man. We'll be all right. What else am I going to do all day? Y'all get anything tonight? I pray. So, look, don't matter how you're coming, just keep coming. In the presence of real love, you'll get set free. If the Father was drawing you near, you'll get set free. Amen? Y'all give God a hand clap.